Hello everyone, in this lecture we'll see a problem based on numerical methods using numerical integration. A problem is evaluate integration 0 to 5 dx divided by 4x plus 5 with 11 ordinates and hence find log 5. Use Simpson 1/3 rule. Solution. So firstly we need to collect the given data. So let I is equal to integration 0 to 5 dx divided by 4x plus 5. Okay, so here the value of a is 0, value of b is 5, and they have said 11 ordinate means n plus 1 form it is. 11 ordinate means n value is 10. So n value is 10 here. So therefore, so with the help of this we can go for the h value. So h is nothing but b minus a divided by n. So b value is 5 minus a value is 0 divided by 10, that is 5 divided by 10. So we'll get it as 1 by 2, which is nothing but 0.5. So once we get this value, so now from the question, so this part what we have, so here again I can say that y value is 1 upon 4x plus 5. So this is the value of y. So we got this all. So we'll think about the construction of the table. So using a calculator, I again will see this one. So go to the shift mode option, option 7. And type this 1 upon 4x plus 5, use fraction. So 1 divided by 4 alpha x plus 5. So equal to sign, starting value, a value is 0, starting value is 0. End value is 5. And step size, that is h value 0.5, so give 0.5. Plus equal to sign, and you can see here, so we got the data completely. So we'll enter this data by using the table now. So we'll construct a table. Now we can see here. So this is x value. So y is equal to 1 divided by 4x plus 5. So all x values I will write. So x values are here 0.5, 1, 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3, 3.5, 4, 4.5, and last one is 5. So we'll write it at. So it is 0, then 0.5, 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3, 3.5, 4, 4.5, it is 0, 0.5, 1, 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3, 3.5, 4, 4.5, and 5. So this is the A value and this is the B value. You can see, so A value is 0, B value is 5. So as per the table, we're getting the same. Now we'll enter by using the calculator, the values here. For 0, what happens? For 0, it is 1 divided by 5. Next, for 0.5, it is 1 by 7. Next, for 1, it is 1 by 9. For 1.5, it is 1 upon 11. So, I am writing in fraction. Then, for 2, it is 1 upon 13. You can see on the screen, it is showing 1 divided by 13. Next. For 2.5, it is 1 upon 15. For 3, it is 1 upon 17. For 3.5, 1 upon 19. For 4, it is 1 upon 21. For 4.5, it is 1 upon 23. And for phi, it is 1 upon 25. So once we have constructed the table, so we'll say this is y naught, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5, y6, y7, y8, y9, and y10. So it is multiple of 2, and just see the formula. So by Simpson's 1/3 rule, that is I is equal to integration of a to b y dx is equal to, it is h upon 3 bracket, so first value plus last value, so first value is y naught plus last value is y 10, okay, plus 4 times bracket, okay. So leaving multiple of 2, so multiple of 2 is y2, y4, y6, y8, and already y10 I have taken, so leaving y2, y4, y6, y8, remaining all will write, that is y1 plus y3 plus y5 plus y7 plus y9, all will come here, plus 2 times multiple of 2, that is y2 plus y4 plus y 6 plus y8 and y10 will come, y10 already. So if you count it, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5, y6, y7, y8, y9, y10. So all y0 to y10, it is coming in the formula now. So next, we need to apply the values now. So therefore, integration 0 to 5, y dx is nothing but 1 divided by 4x plus 5. Equal to h value, so h value it is calculated as 0.5, so we'll enter, it is 0.5 divided by 3 bracket, y naught value from the table it is 1 upon 5 plus y10 value, so y10 from the table it is 1 upon 25 plus next 4 times bracket of y1 value, it is 1 upon 7, y3 value 1 upon 11, these all you have to enter from the table, then y5 value it is 1 upon 15, y7 value it is 1 upon 19, y9 value it is 1 upon 23 plus 2 plus, I will write down here, plus 2 times, so y2 value it is 1 upon 9 plus y4 value it is 1 upon 13 plus y6 value it is 1 upon 17 plus y8 value it is 1 upon 21, close the bracket. So these value will apply in the calculator and see what is the final result here. So we'll see now here. So 0.5 upon 3 fraction I will use, 0.5 divided by 3, then brackets. So here you can see here, 1 upon fractions will use, 1 divided by 5 plus fraction 1 divided by 25. Next plus 4 times bracket fraction 1 divided by 7 plus fraction 1 divided by 11 plus 1 divided by 15, 1 divided by 15 plus 1 divided by 19 divided by 19 plus 1 divided by 23. Okay, so close the bracket. So it is, you can see here, it is showing a block. So at that time, so we have to press equal to sign, then we'll enter the remaining value of this. Okay, equal to sign. So one more bracket and equal to sign. So we got this answer plus. We'll add this. So before adding, we need to multiply 0.5 upon 3 because it is for whole. So we have just applied for this. So we need to apply for this also. That is 0.5 divided by 3, again brackets. So it is 2 bracket 1 divided by 9 plus 1 divided by 13 plus 1 divided by 17 plus 1 divided by 21. Close the brackets and see the answer here. So 0.40252. So I will take that this answer. So 0.4025 I will consider. So therefore it is 0.4025. So it is the answer of integration 0 to 5 1 upon 4x plus 5 into dx here. So this is the required solution here. So now, but in the question they have said that hence find log phi. So to get that log phi, so deduction we call it is. So deduction part. So for that, the given integral will take 0 to phi 1 upon 4x plus phi into dx. So integration of 1 upon directly will go for this one direct result. So one integration of 1 upon 4x plus phi is log of 4x plus 5 divided by 4 limit from 0 to 5. So 1 upon 4. So log of, if you apply upper limit, so 4x plus 5. So apply x is equal to 5, 4 5 is a 20, 20 plus 5 is 25 plus 25 minus lower limit is what here? Lower limit is, if you replace x is equal to 0, so 4 into 0 is 0, so log of 5. So if you calculate log of 25 minus log of 5 divided by 4, if you make, so you will get the answer as 0 point. So here log is there, so we'll use ln of 25 minus ln of 5 equal to divided by 4 you have to take. So you can see 0.40235. So I will 4 decimal place 0.4024. So this is theoretical result and we got a numerical result. So 0.4025 numerically we got and 0.4024 we got. So this is the required solution of log of phi. So from this, so if you multiply 4 to this result, so you will get the value of ln of phi, that is log phi. So if you multiply 4, you will get that same, that is 0.6 result you will get 0. You will get 1.6094 something you will get if you multiply 4 to this. So in this way, we need to calculate the required problem using Simpson one-third rule.